we need to run Proteus. This is the Proteus icon on desktop. Right click the icon and click run as administrator. So it will open up the Proteus software where we can design our circuit and simulate. So what we are going to do, we are creating a new project. Click the new project from the start menu. So when you click the new project, it will open the new project wizard. So give a name of your project. It's a car key. So when you set the key, it will start the car. And this is the location where you are going to save the project. By clicking the browse option, you can change the location. Okay, so just give a name, click the next button, click the next button, click the next button, and click next. So it will open up the schematic design window. Now, what is the purpose of car key in our design? The car key will start the car, that means it will supply the power to the Arduino board. For our design, we are going to use the Arduino Mega. Okay, so this is the Arduino Mega board. Look at over here. This is the microcontroller board that we are going to use for our design. So the key, when you insert the key in the car, it will give power to this Arduino Mega board, so that the system will come alive. So how many ways you can give the power to the board? There are several ways you can give the power to the board. Okay, this is the V-in pin on the board. By this V-in pin, you can supply the power. Now, from the USB board, by using a USB cable, from the power bank or battery, you can give the power to the board. Or from this power jack. Okay, this is the power regulator. How much power you need to supply to the Arduino Mega board? Okay, how much power you can use in the board? Okay, because look at over here, this power regulator. Whatever power you supply, okay, this will regulate and actually it will convert to stable 5 volt. Okay, so you can give more than 5 volt. So let's browse the net and find out how much power Arduino Mega board support. It works usually on 5 volt, okay, but you can give more than 5 volt to the board, but it will convert that extra that means more power to 5 volt, okay, internally by the power regulator. So let's see power requirement by the Arduino Mega board. Give a search on Google. Power of Arduino Mega 2560. Okay. It uses only 0.27 watt. Okay, measured at the electric plug using 52.5 from milliamp per time. It's drawing. Let's see how much power does an Arduino Omega use. Okay, with a 9 volt power supply, the Arduino Omega has a power consumption of 73.19 milliampere. If you reduce the clock speed, the power consumption decreases to 61.76 milliampere. And if you also reduce the power supply from 9 volt to 3.3 volt, you can achieve a current draw of 16.74 milliampere. Okay. How do I power Arduino Omega? The Omega 2560 can be powered via the USB connection or with an external power supply. The power source is selected automatically. Okay, external non-USB power can come either from AC to DC adapter or battery. The adapter can be connected by plugging a 2.1 millimeter center positive plug into the board's power jack. Okay. So how many ampere can Arduino Omega handle? At Omega 2560 can handle, okay, limit of 40 milliampere on each pin and 200 milliampere in total for all pins. Okay, so what we see from here? Okay, operating temperature minus 55 degrees centigrade to plus 125 degrees centigrade. Okay. And voltage on any pin except reset with respect to the ground. Minus 0.5 volt to plus 0.5 volt. Max, okay. Maximum operating voltage 6 volt, okay. Maximum operating voltage 6 volt. DC current per IO pin is 40 milliampere. DC current, VCC and ground pin, that is total is 200 milliampere. Okay, so input voltage recommended 7 to 12 volt you can give, but the limit is 6 to 20 volt maximum limit. Okay, because it is an onboard power regulator. Look at over here. This is the power regulator onboard. So you can use let's say 6 to 20 volt. That's the maximum limit. It has a 54 digital IO pin, okay, of which 14 for the PWM output. It has analog input pin 16. DC current for IO pin is 40 milliampere. DC current for 3.3 volt pin is 50 milliampere. Okay, and this is the flash memory. Okay, 256 kilobyte of which 8 kilobyte used by bootloader. It has static RAM is 8 kilobyte. Okay, so what we see from this data, that it's a very low current device, and for very low current device, we don't need to use any specific or sophisticated system. Okay, look at over here. You can simply just use a manual switch. So go to the component mode and click key and power type button. So simply a button is quite enough, okay, for the key. So what we do by the button, we need to connect the power. So battery, type again key again, type battery. Okay. And we have seen the limit. Let's make connection of the battery. And how much voltage you want to give? 6 to 20 volt. It's a 12 volt battery. Okay, over here. But limit is 6 to 20 volt we can give. So you can take even less than 12 volt, okay, depending on your requirement. So, So if you click, I think, so from here, you see, this is the basic circuit for the key can be, because this is Arduino Mega is a very local device. Okay, so when you just press the button, you just need to connect, and let's pick up the Arduino Mega board. Arduino Mega. So this is the Arduino Mega board, and through wire, you see, you can connect this the USB input or to the power jack or even to the 5-volt VIN pin. You see, PCC 5-volt VIN pin, you can connect. Let me just enlarge it a little bit. Okay. So you can connect this battery to the ground. And this part you can connect over here, or over VCC. Okay. And for the ideal input voltage for VCC, I think you can change it to 5 volt. As you have seen now from our data, you see. Input voltage 6 to 12, okay, so 7 to 12 volt recommended, 6 to 20 volt limit. So, accordingly, you can set up your voltage, okay, what voltage you want to supply. So, this can be the basic key system, because Arduino Mega, this microcontroller board are a very local device. For a low-end device, you don't need to use any relay. But if you want to make your design more sophisticated and there can be different parts on your car, that you may need to use the relay to control different part. For high-current device, there can be other some component on your car system that requires high current. So in those situations, you need to use the relay. And how to use the relay? Let me draw a simple diagram. Okay, but for the main key system, there's no need to use a relay. A simple button will do the job. Okay, a simple button will do the job. When you press enter the key, it will just close the circuit, and Arduino microcontroller board will get the power, and the car electrical system will come alive. Okay, when you remove the key, it will break the circuit, and the car will stop. Okay. So that's the basic system that you can safely use for the Arduino Mega or microcontroller board, because they are very low current device. Okay, but as I have told, that there may be some other equipment or some other device that needs high current. So on the situation, it is a relay. So let me show you how to use the relay. So let me just delete this part. So, how you want to use relay? Then we pick up. So, look at the left side, you need to click the component mode, then click P and type relay. And on the search bar, R E L A Y. Okay. So, animated relay model. Let's pick up this one, basic. Okay, this 12-volt relay is very common. If you see, relay comes in different model in the market. Look at over here. Give a search on Google, relay. Okay, relay. Okay, this is a different diagram for the relay. Okay, relay is usually used to operate high current device. Let's say your switch on the low current side, and to the on and off the high current device, like a motor circuit, okay, you need to use a relay. because motor draws high current. Okay, so these are the different type of relay. Okay, look at over here. This is the mover contact. This is the coil terminal, and this is the I think operate from here. Okay, so let's see how it works. Let's simulate this relay. So relay comes as this is 12 volt 30 ampere relay, 5 volt DC, SPDT, single pole double through power relay. Okay, 5 volt DC. Okay. So if you want to make your design more sophisticated for the car key, then you can use this type of 5 volt relay. Okay, then I think it becomes a more sophisticated design, but it is not actually required. Okay, just simple push button switch you can use, but this will make your design more sophisticated and you can isolate the circuit. So let's see how to use the relay. Okay, so this is the 12 volt relay. You can also use the 5 volt relay depending on your need. Okay, so let's connect the circuit. So if you use that, I think 12 volt relay, then on the switch also you need to use the 12 volt. If you use the 5 volt relay, then on the switch you need to use the 5 volt. But that is these two voltages. Otherwise, you see, if you use 5 volt and it is a 12 volt relay, then it will not work. Let me do the simulation and let me show you. Okay. Let me complete the circuit. Let me use I think a ball to indicate that there's power. Lamp. So when you get the power, the lamp will be on. Let's say this lamp is the output circuit. And you will drive the lamp through other. This is not the source that you are driving the lamp. Okay, you need to give the source. Which source you are going to use to drive to turn on the microcontroller? This is the source that is use another battery. This is the main source or main power to the Arduino board or to the circuit that you will supply from. Okay, so you will connect this power to the output circuit through this relay by using the switch. Okay, so let's connect this battery to our output circuit. Okay, so we have connected the battery to the output circuit. Okay, so look at over here again. This is the relay switch. Okay, we are using a 12 volt relay. And on the switch circuit, we are using a 5 volt. And let's say we want to supply power to our microcontroller board. Let's say 12 volt power, we can give the Arduino Mega. Okay, 6 to 20 volt we can give. So this is the source that will give the power, not this one. Keep in mind, okay, this is the source that will give the power to the microcontroller board. So when we press the switch, this source will give the power. So we need to operate this relay from the key. Okay. So let's simulate. Run the simulation button. If you look at the bottom left corner, the play button, click it. Now look at over here. When we press the simulating, when you press the key, no operation. Why no operation? Because look at over here. This relay is 12 volt relay, and on the switch circuit, we are giving 5 volt. So it will not operate because when you press through the switch, it will energize this coil, it will get magnetized, and it will attract this switch to give supply, connect this power supply to the output circuit. Okay? So we need to give the same. If we use a 12 volt relay, we need to give the 12 volt over here. If we use a 5 volt relay, we need to give the 5 volt over here. Okay, so let's stop the simulation. Let's change the voltage over here, 5 volt. Let's make it a 5 volt relay. Okay, now let's simulate again. Click the play button. Okay, press the key. You see? Now relay is working. It is a 5-volt relay. Now the switch circuit will have a 5-volt battery. So relay is working and it has connected this power source. This is our the power source, main power source that we want to use to power on the Arduino Mega board. So it has connected the power source to the output circuit and the light is on. Remove the key, disconnect the power source, light is on. So this is the substitute circuit that you can use to on and off your car system. And also this type of relay circuit you can use to drive a high current device to the low current system, low current switch. So that's the use of relay. Plus relay can be used to accelerate the different circuit, okay? Because if you use this type of relay, then your main circuit is isolated from the key circuit, okay? I think they are connected by the relay. So this is a good way to implement electrical circuitry in your system. So this is the circuit that we can use for your key system, okay? Press the key, insert the key, light is on. That means you supply this power supply or you connect the power supply to the Arduino Mega board or Arduino Mega board, and your system will come alive. And you can then manipulate your car system. Remove the key, power is cut off. You see, power is cut off. Power is disconnected, and your system is off. So this is the simple circuitry for the car system that you can use for your design. So once you design the entry point to the car, next step to design the main circuitry for your car system.